Hey there! Welcome to Life Noggin. The moon is our closest celestial neighbor. It's fairly small, has a similar makeup to Earth, and there's water. It might sound like an ideal place to set up camp, but it's really not. So why can't we live on the moon? In the last decade, there's been a lot of hype about humans going back to the moon. Japan's space agency JAXA was planning to have a fully functional moon base by 2020, but that plan fell through. NASA declared they'd have one built and fully staffed by 2024, but their plan shifted to an orbiting lunar station rather than a surface one. Clearly, there's a reason these ideas keep getting nixed. Let's start with some lunar basics. Days and nights are a lot different on the moon. Daytime and nighttime last about 14 Earth days each. It can reach 250 degrees Fahrenheit during the day and drop to -380 degrees Fahrenheit at night. In order to survive in this kind of environment, everything from space homes to space cars to space suits would need to be built to function in varying extreme temperatures. And that's just the start of it. The moon has basically no atmosphere protecting it from the constant barrage of harmful UV rays from the sun. These solar rays can do some serious damage to your fragile human bodies, especially during solar storms when the moon's surface can be hit with hundreds of rems of radiation. If you're struck by radiation levels like that without protection or treatment, there's a 50% chance you'll die. Fun. Gravity is another problem. The moon's gravity is 1/6 that of Earth's. Levels that low drastically weaken your muscles and bones and even changes how your heart and nervous system function. The moon's environment isn't ideal for building either. We'd need things like homes, power generators, schools, and hospitals. The moon's surface is covered in a layer of something called lunar regolith. This lunar regolith is basically a mixture of ground up stone, minerals, and glass. Across the surface, depths vary from about 15 to 30 feet. And it's really hard to dig through. Astronauts even had problems with regolith during the short Apollo missions. It built up in their spacesuits and equipment, stiffening joints, freezing switches, and disrupting hydraulics. People have argued that since regolith is partly made of oxygen, we could mine that oxygen to create water, breathable air, and rocket fuel. But in order to do that, the regolith would need to be heated over 1,500 degrees Fahrenheit. And getting machines to the moon that could heat up that regolith, as well as ones to construct buildings and generate energy, would be tricky to say the least. NASA's upcoming rocket, the Space Launch System, will be the agency's biggest rocket to date, but will still only have room for 4 astronauts. No extra room for things like water processing machines or building materials that we need to live on the moon. So yeah, we're gonna need a bigger rocket. But let's put all these formalities aside and think about the cost of colonizing the moon. It's estimated that a small base for 10 people would cost about $10 billion. That's half of NASA's annual budget. Then add in the cost of upkeep, food and supply delivery, power generators, infrastructure creation, all those kinds of things. That would add up pretty quickly. We should ask Elon Musk if he has any spare change lying around. So despite all this, would you still want to try living on the moon? Are there any moons or planets you want us to talk about? Let us know in the comment section below, or tell us, what should we talk about next? On the topics of space and moon and rocks, my friend Natalie is a professional gemologist. She's making awesome videos about gems, fossils, crystals, meteorites, and all kinds of gemstone-related stuff. Natalie makes 2 great videos a week, and I highly recommend you subscribe. She just made a video about if it rains diamonds on Saturn. Check it out.
But once they reach the end of their downward trek, the high pressure and temperature is so intense, scientists theorize the diamonds begin to liquefy.
As always, my name is Blocko. This has been Life Noggin. Don't forget to keep on thinking.